In this video, we are going to show how you can manage the lifecycle of your Tanzu Kubernetes Grid clusters using Tanzu Mission Control. This is our agenda. First, a brief overview of setting up management clusters. Then, we will take some time to provision a cluster using the Tanzu Mission Control console. Next, we will review some of the Tanzu Mission Control features, including the catalog, access control, and policy management. And then finally, we will go to vSphere and inspect the cluster we just created. This is the Tanzu Mission Control console. As you can see, there's a launch pad to assist on day one and beyond. We're going to have a look at the administration area. This is the administration landing page. From here, we can manage this instance of Tanzu Mission Control on behalf of our users. We're going to have a look at the management clusters. We see this instance already has four management clusters, and by clicking on one, we can see more detail. Note, setting up management clusters is considered a one-time activity and is not required in order to manage the lifecycle of your Tanzu Kubernetes Grid clusters. Notice this management cluster has two provisioners. Each of these are configured to use different resources in vSphere. Now we are going to show how our users can create a Tanzu Kubernetes Grid cluster using Tanzu Mission Control. Here we see all the clusters being managed by this instance of Tanzu Mission Control. Notice we see clusters in all of the major cloud providers along with vSphere. If configured, we can manage cluster lifecycle and EKS as well as Tanzu Kubernetes Grid. Here, we choose the management cluster we wish to use and click Create Cluster. Next, we choose a provisioner. In this example, we've chosen W4HS12-dev-ns, but this would be specific to your instance. We then name the cluster. In this case, we're going to name it TKG Demo. And here we can also add optional description and labels as needed. Next, we accept the defaults for the Kubernetes version and the networking configuration. We then choose the storage class. In this case, we're choosing the vSAN default storage class. And click Next. Here, we can select the control plane. We can choose between a single node recommended for development environments or a highly available control plane for production environments. Here we're going to choose the single node for development environments. Now we can choose the number of, or configure the number of worker nodes we want in our cluster. In this case, we're going to choose three worker nodes. And then we can also add, by the way, additional labels, taints, and so forth. And then we can simply click Create Cluster and see our cluster created. Now we get a message in the console that tells us our cluster is being created. Let's jump over to vSphere and see what's actually going on. Here we are in vSphere. We're going to go ahead and go into Workload Management. And here we're going to choose the management cluster we chose, or namespace we chose. And we can see here the TKO demo cluster is being created. That's one we just created a few minutes ago. That's going to take a few minutes. So while this cluster creates, let's go back to Tanzu Mission Control and review some of the features that are available. Okay, here we are back in Tanzu Mission Control. And now we're looking at the catalog. The catalog exists so that our users can easily deploy software that they might need to manage their business. Next, we can look at access. In this case, we can see the access management for our clusters or workspaces. If we choose our cluster we just created, we can see the access policies inherited, and we could also add direct access policies if so inclined. If we go into policies and assignments and choose our cluster, we can see the security policies that are enforced, and we could create more if needed. We can see policies that manage access to the image registry. We can see policies. We can set policies that manage the network or mutation. And this is really powerful because this lets us manage our clusters either directly or as a work space or as a cluster group. And so that all of our clusters are, we can ensure all of our clusters have consistent policies applied wherever they might live. Now let's go see if our cluster has finished creating. We can simply search for our cluster here, and it'll pull it up. We could have also navigated to this cluster using workspaces or cluster groups depending upon the setup. If we click on our cluster, we can see that it looks like our cluster is healthy. All the agents and extensions look healthy. We see three nodes that are healthy. And from here, we can also inspect the details of our cluster, such as the nodes that were created. We can see we have four nodes. It's one control plane and three worker nodes. The node pool from here, we have a default node pool. If we want to add more compute, we can add a new node pool. We can see the namespaces that are available inside of that cluster today. We can even look at the workloads. And you can see the different things that got added as part of the cluster creation process. We could also look at add-ons. You noticed a few minutes ago we looked at the catalog. We would see those packages installed here if they were here. And we can also look at inspections. We don't have any for this particular cluster at the moment. But if we did, they would show up here. In addition, if we click on actions over here on the right, we can access this cluster. And what that would do, that would allow us to download a kubeconfig, which we could then use to access the cluster directly. We could do things like add integrations such as Tanzu Service Mesh or Tanzu Observability, now known as ARIA Applications for Operations. But you can do this with one click here, depending upon the configuration of your instance. Let's go over to vSphere and look at the resources we just created. Here we are back in vSphere. And if I click on the menu and choose inventory, I can choose the physical cluster where this is going to reside. I can then choose the namespace that we used, which was the W4HS12-dev-ns. Clicking on that and expanding that, now I can see the clusters that are inside of that namespace. In this case, I can see our TKO demo cluster we just created. And if I click on that, I will see the actual nodes that are in that cluster that we just saw from Tanzu Mission Control. In this case, I can inspect these nodes just as I would any other asset within vSphere. So if I click on the control plane node, for example, I can see that the details that are associated with that. And then the same goes for the TKO, one of the worker nodes as well. So again, you can kind of see the same information. So that was easy, right? What did we just do? We reviewed the admin setup briefly. We then created a Tanzu Kubernetes Grid cluster from the Tanzu Mission Control GUI. We reviewed some of the lifecycle management features of Tanzu Mission Control. And then finally, we reviewed the cluster in vSphere workload management. I hope this helps you in your journey with Tanzu Kubernetes Grid and Tanzu Mission Control. Visit tanzu.vmware.com/techzone to learn more. Thank you.